Blog Talk Radio.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls from all ages, from Covington, Oklahoma, at Stafford Road Street School is now in session with your aunt. And here is your teacher and host, Sean Stoff. Talk Radio, seventh episode of You're On. In fact, we're about six more episodes away from season one ending, and then we're going to take a break for a while until resuming season two in the fall. But for now, class is hereby in session. I am Sean Stoff Sr. I am. Sean Stoff Sr. I am. I am. You may remember me as one of the unmasked ninjas from the Foot Clan and the original Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles movie, so cowabunga! Dude, I want to thank those of you who pulled themselves away from the game to listen to this show. I appreciate you. So you're going to have to allow me to leave the teacher's lounge with the current score of 48-45 Thunder. So I'm out of the lodge and into the classroom. So class is hereby in session. And now, class, for a few formalities, we need to get this out of the way every time. And that stems from the fact that we're promoting this show. If you'd like to contact me, you'd like to contact the show, any questions, any comments, suggestions, complaints, any of the above, you can contact me at youron at btr at ymail.com. And if you'd like to follow us on Twitter, it's very simple. It's / youron with Sean, all one word. And also visit us on our official website, which is www.wix.com/SeanStoff, all one word, / you're on. And also, if you know anybody that's having a birthday, or you yourself are going to be celebrating that reminder as to how many umpteen blank years young you're fixing to turn, drop us a line. That's what the email is for. And let us know. And we will throw a birthday shout out to you on the air. And speaking of birthdays, I have a few that we are going to celebrate and talk about on this show right here, right now. First of all, we'll start with some belated ones. On the 14th, Monday, Mr. Christopher Burnham celebrated his birthday, an outstanding teacher from Tulsa, an outstanding science fiction fanatic, and an outstanding wrestling fan. So, Chris, happy birthday to you. Also, to my birth boy, Sam Doty, happy birthday, sir, on Monday. That covers Monday. Now, yesterday, from the Qua, the Buffalo himself, James Gaffney, Buff, my man, celebrating his birthday. For those of you who don't know who Buff is, all you got to do is see the man coming at you. You'll understand why he goes by the name Buff. Mucho respeto for you, Mr. Gaffney. Happy birthday. And also, to some of this near and dear to my heart, we go back, high school band, but we also go back to the UWE days, Melinda Bearpaw. She celebrated her birthday yesterday. Happy belated, 24 hours ago, Melinda. Today, a classmate of mine, Daryl Riggs, celebrating his birthday. And then Sunday, on the 20th, one of my grade school friends from way back in the day, Jeffrey Kraft, celebrates his. So if I missed you, I apologize you didn't get a hold of me. That's all part of the deal. You got to get a hold of me in order to get this out. But until that happens, here is your birthday shout-outs to all of you. Okay, we got that out of the way. But in saying and doing that, I also have to mention that there's some shout-outs I got to throw out. The first shout-out goes to Jeremy Scott's Critical Mass. Now, you remember Mr. Scott being on the show here a while back, promoting Knights of Cherokee County. He was also promoting his band. Well, he's also got a Facebook page. in which I became a friend today. Although I was friends with Critical Mass since day one, and I'm down with them. But more importantly, and this is a very special shout-out, goes out to the Laundry Lasses of Muskogee. Absolutely love those two gals. They are awesome. They have set me on their Facebook page as their profile picture. And that's awesome. So in saying that, Critical Mass, Laundry Lasses, here's your shout-out. How awesome is that? Too awesome. Way awesome to describe, because I can't say enough nice things about the Laundry Lasses. Now, before I get into my Thunder report, and I'm going to fix that very quickly, I've got to add one more thing. This Saturday, May 19th, here in my hometown of Covington, Oklahoma, the big hustle and bustle metropolis of Covington, at Covington Park from 8 a.m. to 1 p.m., there's going to be a community-wide safety and fun day. It's for all ages. They're going to have track and field events. They're going to have booths, crafts, games, fitness, but mainly safety in regards to bicycle safety, fire safety, first aid safety, more importantly, weather safety. All you got to do is just show up with a non-perishable food item, and if you have any more questions in regards to that, please feel free to contact Barbara at 580-235-8596. That's 235-8596. Talk to Barbara. She'll tell you all about it. She told me about it, and that's how she got on the air here. Now, on to the interview tonight. We're going to have in the house Mr. Jeff Hiller. He is the owner and proprietor of the Castle of Muskogee, and they're celebrating the 17th annual Renaissance Fair. The family went last weekend. We had a blast of a time. Jeff was very gracious to be on the show tonight. Before we get into that, I have to throw the shout out on the Thunder Report. But in saying that, my son Brett, my oldest son Brett, has a new dog. It's a little black puppy with a blue collar, and appropriately enough, his name is Thunder. So to start off my Thunder Reports from here on out, I'm going to say, this is the Thunder Report. Oh, yeah. Okay, how about them Lakers? I'm referring to Monday. I was laughing like Woody in the first Toy Story movie when he teased Buzz saying, Buzz, look at alien, where? You know. But I did the how about them Lakers to the fan or to Lakers fans at work. So this one goes out to y'all. How about them Lakers? So anyhow, okay, that's enough. I could really get into Monday and talking about Monday. Let's start with the pregame show. I don't know about you guys, but for some reason, Charles Barkley just rubs me the wrong way sometimes. I was so excited to get this game underway because Meta World Peace was in our backyard, and I'm not even going to call him Meta World Peace. He's the Artest, formerly known as Meta World Peace. Charles Barkley was just going on and on and on, and all I heard was, blah, 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 blah. And as I said before, at our household, wrestling is Monday night. That's what we've done for a long time. We've missed very few episodes of WWE. However, this game was on in the living room. WWE was on in another room. I was jumping back and forth, until finally WWE just lost. I just sat there. I started watching the game. I was really getting into it. And I got to tell you, the missus, who really isn't into sports, is really getting into this. And had the Ron Artest elbow incident not have happened, I'm not sure she would have been just as into it as she is now. Because even as we speak, we're at halftime. And she's getting into it. I tell you what, Monday was a sea of blue, and tonight is a sea of blue and white. And I tell you, Monday was just Armageddon for the Lakers. I mean, we won season series 2-1, We won by 15 at the peak. We blew them out the first time. We went to the City of the Angels at the Staples Center before they lost in double overtime in the infamous elbow game. The much-hated Artest entered the peak on the 14th, thinking that he'd be cheered like he was at Game 7 at the Staples Center. That wasn't necessarily the case here, but here's the funny thing. The Lakers are currently staying at the Skirvin Hotel, which is infamous for being haunted, and I'm kind of thinking to myself, okay, you know, not only will they haunt Meta World Peace, ha-ha, but Andrew Bynum as well. We can only hope, right? But I tell you what, at the 7:43 mark of the second half, Ron Artest did this WWE-like clothesline, and wasn't called for it. And I got to tell you, there's a bunch of calls that were made before halftime, and I'm pacing like, you know, an expectant father, waiting for the halftime to be over. But Harden's out, Perkins is in, and I got to tell you, Westbrook is really stepping it up. And I got to tell you, I'm speaking for all the patrons right now at the Brick at Covington, was cheering very loudly at the last 30-second mark at the closing of the first half on that one score. Absolutely outstanding. I tell you, as soon as I get off the show, I'm back in there to finish the second half. Thunder up is all I got to say. Thunder up. And also, on a side note, I want to give props out to the Covington T-ball team, the Little Rascals, excuse me, for winning their very first game. It was 14-11, I believe, was their score. So congratulations to the Little Rascals. You guys did a great job, and you're going to have a great season. So had to throw that shout-out out there to those cute little kiddos. They really went above and beyond. It was great. Weather currently outside is 72. It's going to drop down to 59 overnight. Tomorrow, the high is going to be in the 90s. The low is 66. We're going to have high 80s all weekend long with a chance of rain on Sunday. I've been looking really forward to this interview with Mr. Hiller that's fixing to come out simply for the fact that he was supposed to be on last week. But due to conflicting schedules, that wasn't possible. But it was really good for me because we was able to bring Greg Jensen from Splash Zone to promote Splash Zone in the summer season for there. But for right now, the 17th annual Renaissance Fair is taking place